Thank you. Seriously?
Hello everyone! Thank you for joining us to our second exclusive community livestream on Far Cry Primal. We have with us a bunch of awesome guests and hosts, and I'm gonna introduce you to Julien Denet, aka hey. JJ, that has been playing in the previous one. We also have Clark Davies, which is our lead game designer.
Great to be here.
Thank you for joining us.
Cheers.
And we have...
I'm Andrew Benigue. I'm a community manager at Ubisoft, and I'm stoked to be on this live stream.
Yeah, and thanks to all of you for joining us. Today, we're going to give you an exclusive look at the game, and we're going to, you know, throw it straight into gameplay. So, Julien, take it away.
Cool. Thank you.
Right, so what are we doing here?
So we're about to start a mission with the character Jaima, and yeah, we're going to see what she's all about and what she needs.
Whoa. Papa!
Tawinja. Nutaiwanka. Schlauta. Majish padi mama fwai. Duasa shwalim harsar kamas. Shitaugata.
Dwa sashwalim samharsi. Hars hafchu waidam, kwati salka daicham.
Majish washta mama padi. Who kwati salka? Daish. Aish has waidata. Tushi guash.
And she disappeared.
I like her already.
Really cool. So that character is one of the story line character that you meet in the open world.
Yeah, that's right. She's one of our specialist Wenja characters. Jaime is a hunter. Mm-hmm. She's very seasoned, but she's been doing this for a long time. Yeah. And she's really looking, ultimately, for someone to take her place. Oh. That person might well be you.
Maybe you. Awesome. So, and in this mission, you basically scared off the bear that she was chasing, right?
Exactly, that's it. So now it's time to go and find the bear. Mm-hmm. You can see we're using the Hunter Vision mode. Yes. That's new to Far Cry Primal. It's going to help Takar, the player, really focus his thoughts in the world and see the elements that he needs to see in order to track his prey. So you can see the bloodied trails left behind.
Yeah, the attack player.
You can see the animals too.
Yes. Which you can scare away with the using fire. Yeah.
He's going to be scared out, right?
Yeah. Running away.
That little wolf realized mistakes were made. Don't want to take that guy on.
And that hunter vision is basically like a gut feeling, kind of instinct.
Exactly.
Kind of way.
That's it. So you can see anything that's interesting for Takar to investigate in the world is also going to be highlighted.
Yeah.
Like that thing you just saw. Yeah.
And it's really interesting also because we had the club on fire and it gets consumed after a little while.
That's right. Yeah. If you're going to leave a weapon on fire, and you can set all of your weapons on fire in this game, then you'll find that if you leave it for enough time, it's going to burn out. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So the idea would be to set a new one on fire or craft a new one as you need.
Nice. Okay. And we just saw that Julien, JJ, just picked up some meat from the carcass of the wolf.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Meat, you'll need that a lot. You can craft bait with meat in this game, but also you're going to need meat to survive. You're going to eat it. We have a new set of food recipes for you to eat to get health, but also to get various ability boosts temporarily in the world. Okay.
I actually noticed on the mini-map there's some colored leaves. What are those?
Yeah, so that's a recognition of our plant system. Okay. We have different plants in the world. Some of them are specific to different locations. And the plants, you'll combine them with the meat in order to make your different food recipes. Okay. And like I say, you can get some fun ability boosts or just heal yourself.
Yeah. Ooh, what is that?
Looks like part of a man.
Somebody messed with the wrong bear.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
So you keep following the trail that the bear has been leaving behind him?
Yep.
Yeah. Or the blood trails, rather. Ooh. What is this? Savities? No.
And this blood trail mechanic is something you'll see a lot when you're just in the open world, not even just on missions.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, okay. Really nice. Oh, look at this. Just a random... Okay.
Ooh.
He found a more interesting prey. Oh, what are you gonna do?
Yeah.
Run away! Oh, you can scare it with fire, of course.
So you'll find that the animals are roaming across the world.
You're gonna die! Oh. Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, close. Very close.
Heal. You should probably heal up.
Yeah. Oh my god. Those are very powerful animals, right?
Absolutely, yeah. I think it was a saber-tooth or a jaguar.
Cave lion?
There we go.
Oh.
And you'll just find them randomly across the world. Some of them have territories. Some of them are just wandering the world. And, sometimes they're just going to surprise you.
Ooh.
Okay.
Oh.
So you can see, you just passed a piece of wood.
Yes.
And there's collectible wood in the world that you're going to need to help craft your weapons, and also to build up the village, which is going to be your new home base for the Wendja tribe.
And again, for the viewers who are watching us on Twitch and YouTube Gaming, you can ask questions in the chat, and our moderation team will, you know, convey them to us, and we'll answer them with Clark's help.
So it's good. It's good to see that, like, the Hunter Vision will highlight items of interest for you,
exactly.
Like, you know, like a scent trail or whatever, or even just like blood, right? But like you said, the wood that you need, raw materials that you need to craft stuff.
Absolutely, yeah. All the things that are important for Takar to help progress in the world and to complete his objectives, it'll all be there. And you're in full control of that system at all times. Turn it on and off when you like.
Okay. This is the owner of the...
What was
the
this? Oh, right, yeah.
So maybe we're getting closer?
Yeah, I think so too. And it was actually just before, it was an awesome throw where to scare away that jaguar. Nice jumping there. So yeah, we're getting
We're starting to get closer, I think.
I mean, so like, for someone like me who's kind of new to Far Cry, the first thing that strikes me is that this is so vibrant. Like, I love just like the explosion of color.
Yeah.
That's going on.
That's it.
And can you look behind you, JJ?
Oh, yeah.
It's really like vast, open world, you know, landscape.
The world itself, it was really a different place 12,000 years ago.
Yeah.
And we did a lot of research to try and recreate what it could be like. So you can see those trees, they're gigantic.
Yes.
Even the air is different. There was no light pollution, no air pollution back then. So we really put a lot of time and effort into recreating what
these
that kind of world could be.
Really bad day.
Yes. It's funny how you see the paths, you know, on the ground. It's like, yeah.
You know you're in the right, on the right track.
Yes.
I'm curious, actually, while we're tracking the bear, what sort of research would you have to do, right? Because there's, I mean, you can't
there was
go.
No data
yeah, there was,
at the
there's
time.
Like,
sure.
I mean, there's only so much you can.
No, absolutely. I mean, we absolutely enlisted the help of a lot of specialists to help us discover the world itself, but also the people, their behavior, their cultures, their beliefs. And we worked a lot with two language specialists from the University of Kentucky, Andrew and Brenna Bird.
Mm-hmm.
And they really helped us to figure out the language that was being spoken at the time and how we could make it adaptable to a modern audience, how they could understand it, how the characters would speak it.
Nice.
And they really helped us to immerse us in that world.
Is this the bear we're looking for?
I think it might well be. He even has his own cave.
And this is the bear that Jaima was hunting for two sons, like she says.
Exactly. So the bear, he's a pretty tough customer. You set him on fire, but I just saw him run into the water there.
Oh, okay. So he's going in the water to take the fire off?
That's what it looks like.
Whoa. Okay.
But he's a pretty tough customer, too. He's going to try and escape you. He knows you're tough, but...
Yeah.
He's going to take a lot of...
He's interested by
Did he just take that spear out? He doesn't want any.
No, he's still not going down.
I mean, he was just there enjoying his day, and then JJ comes
along.
And it's like,
what are you doing?
Hey, bud.
Ooh, he's getting angry.
Well, I think we've really
made him upset. He's got you. Maybe at first he was like,
he's mad.
Oh, you know.
Oh, there
nice.
We go.
Really cool. Skin the bear. All right.
So you can see you're picking up some useful items from the bear, not just his skin.
Yeah.
But you'll need bone, you'll need his meat.
Yes.
You'll need his fat to set your weapons on fire.
Right.
That hunting loop, we really thought about how it would fit in to the world of Primal mm-hmm. when we were developing it. And we really tried to make everything count.
Yes. Oh. Now Jema is back.
Even after all that, she still wasn't impressed.
But in fact, yeah, you could just see there, she's actually decided to join your village, which is great.
Okay.
You've
really cool.
By helping her out, you've gained her trust, and she's now on board.
Nice. Wow. I hope you guys enjoyed it. That was one of our first exclusive reveal in this live stream.
That was the first look at Jema.
Yeah.
Right? Which is pretty awesome, because one thing we have now is a raffle. Yeah, we're going to be giving away some really cool stuff.
Yes.
And the first thing some of you might have spotted is right on here. So
I don't know what you mean.
So we'll open a raffle now, and then we're going to do it a little bit differently. We'll open a raffle, and then I'm going to show you what you can win. So the first thing is the Tatar dagger. Tatar's dagger himself. I'm going to unbox this so that you can see.
Ooh.
This is so cool. When Matthias showed this to me, it's like, I want one. Can I get one?
Of course you can get one.
Excellent. All right. All right.
Man.
So, Takar's dagger.
Very nice.
And so this is exact replica of the one he uses in game.
It's the kind of dagger that you can craft in the game
okay.
With all the resources that you're going to find in the world.
So make sure you can get a good look at that.
And you can win this
because
by typing raffle in the chat.
Yeah, so it's exclamation point raffle in the chat. You all know the drill by now, but I think this would be the first one, if I'm not mistaken, because it's currently up for pre-order on UbiWorkshop.
Yeah, and there will be the link in the chat. And if you go on UbiWorkshop.com, you can find that dagger.
Looks really awesome.
It is.
Yeah.
I want one. So we'll have to figure that out.
We'll talk afterwards.
Okay. And then, of course, the other thing that one lucky winner is going to win, as you can see, both Matthias and I are wearing some really cool Far Cry Primal t-shirts. You can win that as well.
Yep.
So one lucky winner is going to get themselves to Takar's Dagger and the Far Cry Primal t-shirt, both of which are, of course, available for pre-order on Ubi Workshop.
Yep.
There should be a Mubot link in the description, in the chat, so that you can go and see those items for yourselves.
But
we were just talking about Jema, and one of the really cool things that you guys have, this is super cool. Really excited to be able to show you this. The cosplay guide. Cosplay reference guide, which actually should have gone out a little bit before the stream went up.
Yeah, just before the stream.
Yeah. So those of you who are interested in putting together your own Jema costume now have the tools to do so, because your friendly community team on Far Cry Primal have put this together. This is fantastic. It's got everything that you're going to need, really, to be able to do it. And so when we scroll through, you'll be able to see some of the pages. It's the 360 turnarounds and all of that. You get like the detailed magnification of her costume and all of the little stuff that you need to put an authentic stuff costume to. And if you definitely are going to do this, you should let the tweet them Far Cry Game.
Yes.
Let them see your work in progress and your finished articles.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we love seeing cosplay. That's a fantastic thing.
Yeah, and it's for like cosplay, it can be for fan art, can be for stories, whatever you want to do with the characters of the game.
Yeah.
So we're really happy to be able to show you this. And very soon we'll announce the winner.
Did we have a question? I think we saw some questions actually.
There were some questions, we can pick one.
Let's have a look.
Yeah, you can. So Geekflow, Ubisoft, how do you avoid getting hit by all of the animals? I don't want to be leeched to death bit by bit if I haven't crafted healing salves. That's a good question.
Well, I mean, that's really two questions. I mean, part of it is avoiding getting hit in the first place. Well, you have to be a good player, of course. But we really had to reinvent the whole core combat loop of Far Cry Primal to make it work. Animal hunting is a much bigger deal this time around than it's ever been. And so, of course, you have to really approach animals a lot closer. Mm. You have to use a lot more melee combat. So you're really going to have to figure out the ranges of interaction with these animals.
Yeah.
The good news is all your weapons are throwable. Your spears are throwable, clubs are throwable. And so...
You even have
you have a sling. A sling the rock that you can throw can be upgraded into a full sling, so you can have much longer range and effect with that.
Yeah.
So that's really going to help to keep the animals at bay. Of course, you can light a club on fire, swing it around like a torch, and that's really going to help to repel animals too.
Yeah.
Exactly. And with our healing system, we have a lot of different food recipes that you can craft. You can be picking up leaves and meat in the world to heal yourself. But on top of that, if you find yourself in a tight spot and you've run out, there is the manual healing system, which is always present in the background.
Yeah. We saw Julien hitting the, I think it was triangle button.
Exactly, that's
just,
it.
Like, eating a piece of raw meat quickly, like, some quick boost.
That's it. Yeah. And that'll really help you heal up quickly. But we have the classic longer animations. It's a bit slower, but it will heal you and it'll keep you safe.
And you also have your beast. We talked about the wide variety of weapons.
Right.
I think your tamed beast can also be helpful.
Exactly. And that's really a new part of your arsenal this time around.
Okay.
I think there are something like 17 different beasts in the world that you can tame, and they all have a different role and a purpose for you. So some of them, they're stealthier, they're going to attack stealthily, they're not going to make any noise. Some of them, they're bigger, they're tougher, like the bears.
Yeah.
They're really very tough customers. So you're going to find that you take a bear with you, you can assault an enemy camp very easily, and you can really use the bear to draw away the aggression from you.
Okay, awesome. All right, so I believe we're still running the raffle. We're going to announce the winner very soon. So
we have another question.
Awesome moderation team is going to pick up one lucky winner.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Maria, how was the creative process for this? Did it just click when it was in concept, or did it take a while to get the right feel to what we see today? Another really good question.
It's a really great question. We've been thinking about it a lot. As the development process goes on, we really try to solidify ideas and figure out how it's going to fit into the Far Cry brand, of course. Far Cry, it's a brand that takes you to lawless frontiers, wilderness areas, where you're really off the grid. And the Stone Age, we realized pretty quickly, fits into that mold really well. And that's why we decided to really do a lot of research into it and see if we could really make a full game out of it.
Yeah.
And like I was saying, we enlisted the help of a lot of specialists to help us figure out. We had filmmakers, we had the language experts that I mentioned, anthropologists helping us just figure out how people behaved at the time. So I think with all of those specialists on board and experts, we really were able to develop the full world that you see.
Really nice.
Yeah.
Good job on that.
Thank you.
And funnily enough, if it's the right Moria I can think of, it's a big fan of the Far Cry franchise.
I know, we're aware of her.
I think we even have a picture of her. Like, we went to a museum with her
and
a bunch of other fans, and like we saw, you know, I think it was a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
And we had an awesome time like looking at the different skulls and
that's
animals
pretty cool.
And so
I follow
on,
her on Twitter. So well aware.
So yeah, and we are ready to announce the winner.
We have a winner. So great. Congratulations to Zancorp. You have won yourself Takar's dagger and one of these cool Far Cry Primal t-shirts.
Yep.
And if I'm not mistaken, I wanted to check with Maddie. You're one of the first people in the world to have won this.
Pretty much. Like, we did say it's an exclusive community stream. So
perfect.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So the moderation team will get in touch with you. Just tell her where you want us this delivered and the t-shirt size, and we'll get that your way.
Congrats.
All right, and now we all know you're here for that. More gameplay. So we're going to switch back to gameplay, and we're going to show you another really nice exclusive feed footage.
So JJ's going to do his best not to die. We were a little close last time.
Yeah.
It was all for the show.
Yeah.
So where are we now?
So up until now, we've been in the forest regions of the world, which is where the Wenja people start their game out. But now we're starting to move south. We're heading into Izilla territory.
Ooh.
The Izilla are the most advanced enemy tribe. I'll check that out.
Yeah.
And
it was a random event.
That's it. It's the Far Cry Anecdote Factory in full effect.
Oof. And now they're attacking you. Oh, and running away because they can't really...
Sorry, animals. Not today.
That's what I thought.
Yeah. No, he's chasing you.
He's coming back, is he?
Yeah.
He wants some more.
Yeah, you have to be really careful with these guys. They're pack animals.
They're really smart.
Yeah. If there's just one of them, the dolls, you're probably okay. But when there's two or three, suddenly they're circling you.
Yeah.
You have to be really aware.
Find the best angle.
That's
surprise
it.
You.
Yeah.
Okay, really nice.
They look like hunting dogs, like the hunting dogs of today.
Well, except they have gigantic ears.
Oh, something else.
So you can see there, that's like an acid pit. So there's a lot of dangerous fumes there. You really don't want to get too close to them.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And that was the Azilla.
Yes, that was guarding a prisoner.
Yeah, that you just took down.
Very nice.
So are they native to a particular part of the world, the Azilla tribe?
Yeah, that's right. They're in the southern region of the world where it's a bit more temperate. There's a more swampland. You can see the acid pits there.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll find that they're more advanced than the other tribes in the game. And they're very focused on advancing themselves and their religion.
Okay.
And, of course, they don't really like the fact that the Wenja are around. So mm-hmm. what they try to do is to kidnap them and slave them.
All right. Mm.
But right now we're using the owl, which is one of the great new tools we have in Primal. The owl is really going to help you scout around the world and help to tag enemies for you. But you can see the owl also has some abilities that can be unlocked over time. On the right there, you can see you have the option to drop some of the various throwable weapons in the game, like the bee bomb or the fire pot.
Should we go fire or bees?
Fire always works for me.
Fire?
That's amazing.
And a lot of this is available for you to upgrade over time in the skills menu of the game. You can even have the owl attack enemies for you.
Best owl ever.
So I can see we're switching to a different beast.
Yeah.
This is really going to help you.
Yes.
Tackle the outpost.
Yeah.
It's a pretty tough one.
Yeah. There you go, yellow beast. Yes.
So how do you get beasts over time?
So the idea is that you'll initially meet the Shaman character in the game, and he's going to teach you how to become a Beastmaster.
Okay.
And so at that point, you'll be able to craft your own bait in the world, and if you see an animal in the wild, you throw the bait out, and then you'll have a chance to tame it.
Okay.
Effectively, the idea is to collect them all,
mm-hmm.
and that way you've got the best possible set of options to help you tackle outposts. Julian is killing it right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you mentioned different beasts like have different advantages, right?
Exactly.
Some are more stealthy, some are just brute force.
Yeah, that's it. And they all have a special ability as well. A lot of the felines can actually climb over some surfaces and really help to maneuver around the world a lot better.
Mm-hmm.
The Azilla are pretty cunning, so you're going to need everything you've got.
Yeah.
Nice. And we just saw the sling as well, right?
Yeah,
there,
that's right.
Just before.
That's it. The spear there as well seems to have been upgraded, which is perfect.
Yes.
You're going to need your tougher weapons to take on these guys.
That was the acid pond that we just saw before. That's not water.
You don't want to take a bath in
no.
that.
No.
Oh, no.
Oof.
So yeah, you can give commands to your beast at any time.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's going to help you to target enemies so you can forget about them and deal with someone else.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the beast is fully in your control, right?
Absolutely.
So it's not going to do anything until you've given it the command.
The beast is going to follow you to the best of its ability.
Mm-hmm.
If you start to get into trouble, it's going to help you out. And of course, you can target it at any enemy that you want.
And what is the benefit of taking down the outposts?
Well, the outposts are really the enemy camps that are across the world. You need the outposts to enable fast travel in the world, but most of the outposts also have trapped Wenja inside. And ultimately, you need to gather as many Wenja tribes people back to your village as possible because you want to grow your population. You really want to restore the Wenja to their rightful place in the world. And that all feeds into the progression system where we can unlock new weapons for you, new skills and abilities, and so on.
Okay.
And those two enemies were reinforcements as well, right?
Yes, that's it. I think because we triggered the alarm early on in this one, there's more enemies than usual.
Yeah.
So that's another incentive to play stealthily.
Yeah.
If you go in, take enemies out one by one, don't allow the horns to be blown. In fact, there's a horn blower right there.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Good job. Really
can
good
we
job.
Can we just talk about how expertly you threw that club
yes.
right into that guy's torso?
that was pretty amazing. Intense. Really good job. And we could have done it like stealthily as well.
Absolutely, yeah.
Like, we could have really gone undetected, trying to take it from a different angle.
That's it. That's the beauty of Far Cry. We let you approach these missions in any way you like.
Mm-hmm.
We give you all the tools to do the job, and it's up to you how you want to go ahead and do it.
Nice.
There was never any doubt that JJ had this on control. Never any doubt.
So we have
This guy helped you a little bit.
Yeah, thank you. Can you give it a name?
A name?
I don't know.
When we ask.
I think he just wants you to. I think he just wants you to pet it.
Yes.
It's like, I did good. Can I have a pet, please?
Did I?
Oh, yeah. And that's a great thing. Of course, if your beast takes a bit of damage, that's another great use for meat. Okay. Just to keep him healthy and on your side.
Nice.
There you go. You are.
Awesome. Okay, I guess we have a bit of time for more questions. I don't know if the moderation team has some interesting questions for Clark and us.
Questions? Okay.
Maybe.
Take Freewalkers one?
Yeah.
Yeah. How many different throwable. How much different are the throwable mechanics from the gunplay from earlier games?
Well, the big new feature, of course, is being able to throw all of your weapons. You can see Julian's throwing some clubs there. Yeah. Clubs are great because if you manage to hit an enemy with them, it'll damage them for sure, but it will also stun them. Yeah. And that's a great way, if an enemy is really coming at you, is to take a little breathing room. That way, if he's stunned, maybe there's another enemy you can take on instead. Or if he's the only one, you can use that as an advantage point to get closer, deliver a killing blow.
Yeah, yeah. And maybe Julian can like circle around the different weapons that are at our disposal.
Because it's like you'd mentioned earlier, that obviously the different tribes with the different archetypes of enemies as well. So sometimes throwing a club might not be the best thing. There might be a nimble
exactly,
enemy
type. Yeah. Yeah, with the Azilla, they're a bit more cunning and wily. They're a bit more nimble, exactly like you say. Whereas the other enemy tribe, the Udam, they're a bit bigger and tougher and slower. Okay. Throwing a club is going to help to stun them, but it's not going to stop them, for sure. Yeah. I can see we've switched to a spear there.
Yeah.
With the spear, and in fact, with all the weapons, you have an upgrade path for everything. So at the start of the game, it'll be a fairly straightforward wooden spear. But eventually, it's you're going to want to upgrade it. Again, you want to collect everything in the world. You want to find the different wood types, the binding materials to help tighten everything together, bone, flint, and so on. And it's going to help you to make all the weapons that you need to take on the world.
Yeah. And I don't know if you can see it, but the day is starting to transition into night.
Yeah, absolutely. The day-night cycle has never been more important for us than in this game. You can see that as we go into night, things are getting darker.
And
this is where fire really comes into its own.
Wow. And the atmosphere it gives is it's pretty cool.
That's it. Again, there's no light pollution 12,000 years ago, so you're going to see a very different experience.
Yeah.
And especially when you go into the cave systems in the
game. Which is what I'm going to do now.
So lighting a torch, it's the number one priority for you when you go into these caves.
Really nice.
But as Matthias had mentioned earlier, one of the things with lighting things on fire is they burn, and they slowly burn down, right?
Yes.
Like you can see it happening to you.
Like right now, it's about at the rope level.
Exactly.
And in a few minutes, we're going to see it's like progressively burning away the.
So if you leave it out over time, it's going to burn down. You're going to have to discard it and craft a new one and set that on fire. Oh. And it's up to you. You have full control as to when you want to set a weapon on fire and when you want to extinguish it. You could save it for later if you needed to.
Oh, nice.
But of course, here in the cave, you're going to need the light source for sure.
Yeah.
This cave is really big. It's a maze. Yeah. And finding your way around, you're going to need a light source.
Mm-hmm. And it's so impressive. It's like, you know, very tight sometimes.
Enclosed space. Yeah, that's it. But we also get to see things like the grappling claw coming into use here because the world of Oros is very vertical. There's a lot more natural blockers in the terrain.
Mm-hmm.
And so you're going to need to use your grappling claw to get up and down through tight spaces and up the sides of mountains a lot more.
And here, Hunter Vision again, to check if maybe there are some...
Exactly, that's a really smart thing to do.
Or something.
So down here, you look to be pretty safe.
Do you think you could explain one thing to me? Because I've noticed it, I've seen it on the minimap. I have no clue what it is. The little dotted lines on the minimap. What's going on there?
Well, that's basically, it's your trail. So it's a new addition for Far Cry Primal. Because we have a lot more interesting choices with the terrain and the navigation, and especially these cave systems. Having the trail come up behind you is just going to help you figure out where you are in the world, where you've been, and therefore help you to figure out where to go next.
So like the proverbial breadcrumbs, as it were, so you find your way back.
That's it.
Really nice.
And I see your pet managed to join you as well, which is fantastic.
Yeah. And we can see the burned
The club is starting to burn down a bit more there, so you're going to have to be careful. Now.
Really nice. And I like how the sound is different from in the open world.
Right.
Here it's like really like resonates.
Exactly.
Much more.
It's a very different experience.
Yeah.
But I can imagine that plays a, like, you know, as Maddie has just said, it plays a huge, huge role in a game like this, right? Because it's, you know, a lot of the terrain is different, but of course it's very vast and open, right? So it's
exactly.
Like sound design plays a huge role in Far Cry.
Yeah, that's it. We need to really sell the ambience of the world a lot more without modern day sounds like you've seen in other games. Mm-hmm. It really gives us a chance to show how the world really was mm-hmm. back then. So you can hear a lot more animal noises at night. And when you're in a cave, of course, it's a very different ambience.
Yeah.
And there was an interesting question from Duane Dibley-Smeg. Can you light different areas by placing torches on walls or items?
Yeah, sure. So, well, we have across the world the bonfires. Mm-hmm. These are gigantic sort of piles of wood that have been set up, and they're just waiting to be set on fire. Mm-hmm. You're going to use them in the world to help claim your territory. Mm-hmm. And also, when you're at a bonfire, you can rest. Right. You can access your stash of items.
Yeah.
And you can use it as like a marker point mm-hmm. to help get around the world.
And we also saw JJ like burning a piece of like...
yes, that's it.
Plants that were like hiding an entrance or like a little hole.
Yeah, in some cases, you'll need to burn down things to get access to different areas.
Ooh.
Oh. And you'll find there's little symbols in the world which are going to help you understand what you need to do.
I was about to say, you know. Ah.
So that little bird painting, it's to help you understand that there's a grapple point nearby.
Yeah, it's like a hint.
Yeah, exactly. And
where is this one?
The white hand painting there, it's a little wall that, in fact, you can break through.
Ah,
and you can
okay.
access a secret area.
Ooh. Really nice.
To continue exploring.
Mm-hmm.
It's great because, of course, it ties into, like, what is the feedback loop, right, in the whole game. You get the cues and the little, you know, clues as to what's going on in
exactly.
the environment.
That's it. We try to put as much feedback into the world as possible, and... for the cases where there are still HUD elements around,
this
we've
really
retained
nice.
Our interface menu, so you can turn everything off if you really want a completely immersive experience.
Mm-mm.
And yeah, another little sign there, the little fireflies, helping to light your way.
Fire as well on the torch.
Yeah. Gives that nice little graphic effect of the darkness. Very nice.
I love those touches because it makes you feel like a hunter, right? You feel like this is what I'd have to do if I was out in the wilderness and I'm trying to find my way or I'm trying to survive and get food. Like, you're gonna have to listen out for, you're gonna have to track different things. Like, you see a little disturbed bit of reed and you think, huh, something passed through here, right? And you focus all of your effort and your attention into trying to find these things. So
you have much more hints in the nature that
that's
you need to,
Far Cry's always done a really good job of putting you into the mindset and role of a hunter, and it's never been more true than in Primal. You can really see that being a hunter-gatherer is actually what people's day-to-day job was back 12,000 years ago.
Yeah. Whoa.
So we're going deeper and deeper into the cave.
Yeah.
Seems safe so far.
Looks safe.
Gotta check.
Yeah. Better check indeed.
Ah, and I think we found a cave painting.
Really nice.
That's awesome.
So that's great. It's just another way of showing how the world really was back then. People would,
Well done, JJ.
Oh, really cool. Well done.
Excellent.
Indeed. Can you, you were saying that wall painting kind of, because I think in the chat they were mentioning there was someone asking about those.
Okay, yeah. So those are the cave paintings. So you're going to find them scattered across the world and often hidden in these caves. And talking of caves, you actually have your own cave back in the Wenja village.
Right.
And as you slowly progress through the game, as you complete the different missions and quests and find these cave paintings, your own cave is going to become bigger. It's going to have more paintings itself generated inside it, you're going to really feel that you're starting to take over the world.
Okay. Well, now we just finished our second exclusive gameplay reveal, and we're going to open another raffle. So, moderation team, if you can open the raffle again, type !! raffle in the Twitch chat. And up for grabs are very interesting items. So I don't know if you saw, but we announced the soundtrack that is available, made by Jason Graves. So it's on the website. We have a news there. You can also listen to a free soundtrack that we published on YouTube. There should be the link in the chat window. Yes, we have those two items. We also wanted to talk about the Primer Guide, which is it exists in two versions, a physical and a digital copy.
That's great.
And we're giving away one today as a bundle with the t-shirt that we are wearing, Andy and I. So that's what you can win in the raffle today, the t-shirt that Andy and I are wearing. Plus the version of the Prime Guide that we will send.
Those Prime Guides are really good.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
I'm not ashamed to admit that I've had to use them in the past to try and get, like, you know, completely finish a game with collectibles and stuff. They're really detailed and really good, but not in like an overwhelming way, right? They they take you step by step and stuff. So that's definitely, like, I'm jealous. Whoever wins that,
we'll talk after the stream again. You know, don't worry about it. No, and the Prime Guide, like, you can also have it on your cell phone.
Yes.
Like, instead of having the book, which you can also have, you can also have, like, just pop up the cell, look at the guide, and, like, help you while you play.
So what's your preference?
Really handy.
Do you want to have
I like both. Like? It depends on the situation. Maybe, like, you know, at home, I will just, like, drop on the couch, open the book, and, like, read through it. And then when I play, I will just be like, oh, what is this again? Okay, this is what I need to do, for example.
What about you, Clark? Are you allowed to admit that you use Primer Guides?
I have to say, I was really impressed with the quality of the Primer Guide that I saw from Far Cry 4, and I can't wait to see the one that we're going to produce for Primal.
Yep, yep. And talking about sound just before, well, there's the soundtrack, but there's also three audio experiences that we shared recently this week. I think it was last week. Basically, you saw the different, you know, environments that we saw, you know, the like swampy kind of area, the temperate forest. And here we have where the Udan live.
Yeah, that's in the northern region of the world, the more icy, mountainous areas. You can see there's some sort of red plant types scattered around. It's really helping you to understand that you're transitioning from the forest regions into the Udan regions. Yeah. And of course, every region in the game has got an exclusive plant that really grows only in that space.
Okay.
And again, you'll need those plants to help heal yourself with meat, but also to get different buffs and effects on yourself as a player.
Nice.
The one that you'll find up in the Udam region is going to help you fix yourself as an antidote to poison.
Okay. Very interesting. And I don't know if the viewers can hear that, but there's the surrounding sound, the audio immersion kind of, that you can watch on YouTube and like use as a, almost like those little apps, like, you know, with wave sounds or rain sound that you use to go to sleep. You can actually use that too, like, to be immersed in the Udam environment.
Excellent.
So that's on YouTube. It will be posted on the chat. There's also a second environment that we wanted to show you. There are three in total. The second one is the marshland.
Yeah, that's right. That's the southern area. So we were just spending a few minutes there when we attacked the Azilla camp.
With the outpost, right?
Exactly, that's it. So it's the southern area of the world. It's a temperate marshland. Mm-hmm. And it's where the Azilla have developed rudimentary farming techniques.
Mm-hmm.
One of the first tribes to actually do something like that.
Right.
So we took that as part of our research and integrated it into the game as well.
Very nice.
And it's a beautiful environment.
Yeah, and here again, if they can hear the sound, it will be like a much more swampy, kind of like wet terrain almost.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. That sounds like my kind of place.
Oh, yeah? How so?
Well, I mean, where I'm from, it's kind of like, it's tropical.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, right. Okay, and we have the third sound, which I guess the viewers can guess which one it's going to be. It's the temperate forest.
Yep, that's it. So it's really the starting area of the game. It's the place where you're going to use as your home base to help expand your Wenger village over time. It's where you're going to find a lot of different resources that are going to help you to build that village up, and also where most of the different animals are going to live as well. Like the other regions, there's animals that you're going to find exclusively in different areas of the game. Mm-hmm. And there's animals as well that will come out at night separately from in the day too.
Okay, really cool. Yeah. And it's got a much more, like, we were talking about how high the trees are, and like it's just got much more like a crackling sound, the birds and, you know, the trees that have some kind of almost personality. I don't know.
Exactly.
How
no, it's true. I mean, because you really will feel it when you play the game and you walk up to your first tree and you realize it's like 20, 30 feet in circumference.
Yeah.
And it's a very different feeling than you would have had in any previous game.
Wow, impressive. Okay. I think we are almost closing the raffle, so we'll pick a winner very soon. Again, the winner will get a t-shirt. Any size, you know, you just tell us which size you want, and he will get a Primer Guide.
Oh.
So, you know, the moderation team will soon pick the winner, the lucky winner, you could say.
Far Cry got you covered on some really cool price packs.
Yes.
I'm actually curious, so which is your favorite area of the game?
I think it's the northern region, the Udan one. And in fact, we're probably going to see some of that pretty soon. Mm-hmm. It's maybe. Sorry, spoiler alert.
That's fine.
It's got a very interesting terrain type and some very interesting gameplay associated with it as well. Okay. So perhaps I shouldn't spoil anymore.
No, it's fine.
This is an exclusive stream as it is anyway. Yeah. So
exactly.
Everything here
is fine, Clark. Cool. And we actually have our second winner.
Yes, we do.
Great.
Congratulations to Zone 909.
Yes.
You've won yourself a Primer Guide and one of these fantastic t-shirts.
Yeah.
These are really cool tees.
Yes,
but
they
yours
are.
Is different.
Mine is a bit different.
Yours
yeah.
is different.
It's a little darker.
Is that the dev team one?
It's the dev
is that
team
the
shirt.
Special
yeah,
one?
There it is. with the same logo, but
yeah.
It's a slightly special. Different design.
Yeah, yeah. So, it's got like different textile. Like more like VIP dev textile. Yeah.
They're very nice to us, what can I say?
Yeah.
So I should admit something really quickly, and I told Matthias this before we came on. But when I had seen the logo for Far Cry Primal, I wasn't quite sure what was going on. I could make out some teeth and everything. And then I saw the dagger.
Yes.
And then I realized it's the same dagger that's through a skull.
Yes.
I had a moment where I was like,
No, exactly. There's little saber tooth here. And the dagger, like, just planted in it. It's really nice.
Cool.
Okay. Oh, there you go. I don't know if you can see it.
Sweet. Yeah, do we want to take some more questions before we move on?
Sure. We can move on and show some questions.
Okay, you can do both.
No, let's see.
The size? Because we already answered that one, didn't we?
I guess we can answer this one.
How big is the map?
How big is the map?
Sure, It's a big map. Honestly, this is a full-size Far Cry game.
Mm-hmm.
The map, if you've played Far Cry 4, it's very comparable in size.
Yep.
And of course, because, like I was saying, the terrain is different, you'll find that it's going to take you just as long to get from one end to the other.
Yeah, because it's so big, right?
And exactly.
It's very dense. Mm.
That's it. A lot more verticality in the terrain, a lot more animal density in the terrain.
Yeah, we saw that.
I think
JJ
Far Cry...
always getting attacked.
Exactly. Far Cry has always been really generous in terms of the content that we ship with. Mm-hmm. Far Cry Primal is no different.
Okay.
We have just as much, just as many side content in terms of extra missions and quests and collectible items.
Yeah.
We have a gigantic skill tree. Crafting is much more improved than it has been in previous games.
Yeah, we saw that.
Yeah,
and we can actually switch to gameplay now. So this is the third reveal of this community stream. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Yeah, it may have been spoiled a little bit.
No, it's
because
fine.
You still have to see
it. Was teased.
You still have to see it.
Yeah,
that's it.
So here we're still in the Temperate Forest area, but I think we're getting closer to...
Exactly. We're about to move further north. We're about to move into Udan territory.
Ooh.
You're about to see how things are going to start to change for you visually, but also in terms of gameplay.
Yeah.
So can you give us a little bit of context on the Udan tribe then? Like, how they are existing in the world and why?
Yeah. So
pretty much why.
So basically... Why? They were trapped for a long time in this northern region by the glaciers as they moved in from the Ice Age. And not having access to the rest of the territory and to civilization in general, they had to retreat into themselves. It turned them into cannibals. But they also had to resort to inbreeding. So we find that the Udam are a very primitive tribe. They're very angry. And they definitely don't like the fact that now that the glaciers have started to melt, and they've started to explore the world around them.
Mm.
They're discovering that there's other tribes present and they really don't want to share that space with them. So in fact, we're going to see coming up as we start to move further into that territory, the remnants of that Ice Age. You're going to see the area becoming more icy, and you're going to see the old glaciers.
Yeah, and I like, because we can hear the sound of the snakes,
yes.
And I like how JD is like, we can't
there's something close
that
by.
Snake.
And that's another
voice to strike as well.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Sneaky little thing.
Yeah, well, they are so low on the ground, you can't see them because of all the vegetation.
Yeah, that comes back to what we were talking about, sound design, right?
Yes.
It's like we could hear it, wouldn't it?
Where
is it?
No, it's super important.
That's it, and there's a lot more grass that's longer and deeper, so there's more opportunities for snakes to hide in that.
Yeah.
And if you're not, you'll need to use your hunter vision
in
order to help spot them.
Yeah, and survive.
I love that these random events just happen.
Yes.
There's a bear just trying to get some dinner.
That's exactly it, yes.
One thing that you did mention, look at that scenery.
Beautiful.
Look at that.
Impressive.
Is that where we're heading? No, we're not heading there.
quick.
Mistakes were made. Take some meat and slide down
there. Okay,
yeah, that's good. Safe for now.
Safe for now, yeah. Wow. Really nice landscape.
The bear's thinking a missed meal.
Yes. Well, I just got one. You know, there was a little animal.
But yeah, if I were trapped in a glacier for God knows how long, I'd be angry too. I mean, I'm angry here when it gets cold.
Yes. That's pretty impressive. And all those, like, mountains and, like, you know, verticality that you were talking
exactly.
about.
Exactly. So even just to get closer, you're going to have to climb a lot.
Yeah.
But it adds to that sense of scale, right?
Like yeah.
When you pan across and you just see those snow-capped mountaintops and you think, wow.
It's the mountainous area, so it only makes sense that you have to climb to it.
Exactly.
And already, like, the trees, you know, have less leaves and are more, like, skinny.
Yeah, they're obviously dying and wilting in the colder temperature. Mm-hmm.
That's fascinating. Really nice. You can see that transition, right?
Yeah.
From like luscious vegetation to barrenness.
Yes. And like more narrow terrains, more mountains. Pretty impressive. It changes completely from what we saw with the outpost in the Isida.
Exactly.
The marshlands or, you know, the temperate forest, kind of like wide hills.
So I'm assuming that, like, obviously, like, as you've mentioned, with like the plants, there's some that are unique to each territory. Mm. It would be the same with like beasts as well, right?
So. Exactly. There are some animals you're already going to find in different regions of the world. The cave bears exist mostly in the northern regions, in the caves, of course.
Yeah. Okay.
And it's starting to snow. I don't know if you saw that.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So here we are. We're really right at the edge of their territory now.
Right in the heart of Udam country.
And obviously, when we talk about snow, we talk about cold.
The cold, that's it. So, when you first play this game, you're welcome to venture north. The whole map is open from the start of the game. Okay. But something you'll realize really quickly is that if you do go north...
You can.
And absolutely, you can. But you'll realize that it's very cold up north.
Yes.
And if you stay in the northern region too long, you're going to start to die from the cold.
Yes.
And so your objective when you're north is to start to find a fire, light a fire, get warm. Alternatively, you have an option where you can craft some protective clothing from our crafting menu. You'll need to find some animals to take their hides and use that to form some clothing.
Yeah.
And that's really going to help you to survive for longer in the world.
Okay.
I wanted to point something out because I spotted it in the chat just before we begin this. Somebody is not convinced that JJ is playing.
Oh, yes. No,
he was like,
live.
Nobody plays this way.
No,
this has to be
pre-recorded.
So could we just prove...
Yeah, do something, like jump.
Just spin around, spin it.
Yeah, spin around.
He's playing. I would just like to point that out.
Okay, no, this is live.
This is going on right now.
Yeah. Thank you for pointing that out.
No problem.
So yeah, and now we're really deep into Udam territory.
Yeah, you can see, obviously, there's snow on the ground. It's starting to get really cold. I think Julian was smart enough.
Like when you walk,
that's it. You can hear the snow crunching underfoot.
Mm-mm.
I think Julian was smart enough to already craft his winter clothing.
Yes.
But as a new player, you're going to have to go through that process.
And here we're going to play an exclusive reveal mission.
Yeah.
Well, it's a side quest almost, right? Mission.
So there are Wenja that are scattered all over the world, and as well as gathering all the specialist characters like Jaima, you're also going to have to find these stranded Wenja.
Right.
And in this case, they need to be escorted to a place of safety.
Mm-hmm.
And ultimately, the more Wenja that you find and help in the world, it's going to build your overall population of your village.
Yeah.
And the higher the population gets, the more rewards are going to be unlocked for you.
Okay. Very cool.
Okay, so while that is happening, just to point out again, because we've seen somebody else going, but how do we know this wasn't pre-recorded? Because I'm answering your question right now.
Yeah, we are. Can you give him a shout
it's
out?
It's live. Yeah. I see your question in the chat, hence, by the power of technology, we are answering it straight away.
And thanks to our awesome moderation team behind the cameras.
This is live.
Allowing us to see all your questions. Keep, you know.
But then, how are we doing? This wasn't planned as well.
I mean, oh my God. No, I don't know how we can actually prove it. I guess we could ask, like, how many fingers, you know, am I showing? No, I don't know. But yeah, no, he is playing live. Oh, all right, whether the Wenja.
These are your tribes people.
That's it.
Yeah.
So yeah, they've been scattered across the world, and now you're starting to find them and interact with them.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to help them, of course.
Yeah. And they have this little, green diamond icon?
Yeah, it's going to help you to just keep a track of them as they move across the world.
Okay, okay.
And of course, it's going to help you know whether they're alive or dead.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, you can see them on the minimap.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ah, he's scouting the group now. Good luck.
He doesn't need luck. He got this.
He's got skills. Ooh, where are you? Wolves. Much bigger wolves.
Yeah, I was just going to say, that's the biggest wolf I've ever seen.
So we did a really good job of trying to promote not just variety between different animals, but variety within animal types. Mm-hmm. And we have several different species of wolf in the game.
Yes.
And of course, you can tame them and have them travel with you as well as companions.
Nice. Right.
Oh, I don't think they'd like the fire.
No. Well, it is dangerous, so...
That wasn't smart.
But it shouldn't last too long in this temperature.
Yeah, because it's so cold, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't last long. Okay. It's also nice to see the fire propagation, kind of.
That's
it,
yeah.
That's always something that's fascinated me, watching it happen in real time, as it were.
And how the ground is burnt afterwards, like no vegetation, just like dark earth. Okay.
So there we go. Yeah. I think we're getting safe.
Yes.
Poor wolf, rest in peace. Yeah. He took one to the head, look at
that. Yeah. And you can skin it for the crafting ingredients.
Absolutely, yeah. You'll need his skin. It's going to help you make different bags to carry your weapons.
Yes.
But also you'll need some of the skins to help build the village huts as well.
Right, yeah. Okay.
But it's also handy to see, we saw a little thing, and it's a little thing that sometimes gets overlooked, but you used your weapon to kill that animal, and then you went to it, and you were able to recover it.
Exactly.
Right away.
Yeah.
And another version of the bow that we haven't seen.
Ooh, doubles.
So this is actually one of the later game bows, and... Yeah. What we have is that with the bows, we have three or four different bows, and the idea is that when you unlock them all, you've got strategic options.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
The double bow, of course, is going to be super powerful.
Yeah. Okay.
And nice. That was your first glimpse at the Udan there as well.
Yes.
Yeah, you said it. They were a lot bigger and slower than any of the other ones that we've met before.
That's it.
Double bow plus headshot equals wrecked.
Some more Udan.
So yeah, I guess those first couple of Udan were more of a scouting party.
Mm-hmm.
So chances are there's a lot more nearby.
Yes. Oh yeah, no, of course. Was that the sound that we heard? Was that Udan?
I think it was. Yeah. And here they are. Yeah.
Language.
Ooh. Took one to the head.
This is where you threw
the
club.
Club there. Yeah. Great use of the strategy.
Yeah. Oof. Yes. You're safe for now.
For now.
No, it's very interesting because obviously you've got the human, the Udam tribe that wants to kill you, but you also have the animals.
Exactly.
Just wants to...
The world itself is just as much of an enemy as the enemy tribes.
Yeah. Oh.
Watch your step.
Yeah. Careful.
I love how they hang back. Like, yeah. No, you're
like,
good.
You go first.
Yeah, you got this. Check it safe.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what's that?
Okay.
I don't think we want to disturb that.
Looks like a saber-tooth.
Like, quick. Run away.
She's like, but I could take it.
Oh no!
Sneak attack.
Sneak attack indeed.
That was quick. Oh man.
Oh yeah. There's like too many of them. Ooh. Oh. Okay, it's fleeing.
Oof.
Whoa,
yeah,
close.
These guys are really tough.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Good job.
I was worried for a second there.
Yeah, me too. I was like, whoa. And
for a big cat, it moved super quickly.
Its fur was like, more according to the terrain. So yeah. Really interesting.
Yeah, we didn't see that until it was literally right above us.
Yeah.
So here you can see these are some scarecrow type artifacts that the Udam have put into place to help scare away the other tribes.
And it's working.
They don't look very friendly.
No.
Oh, I think we have trouble up ahead. It actually looks like a graveyard.
Yeah. So many of them.
Good shot.
Yeah.
Oh no, did we lose one?
I think we did.
We lost someone.
Oh.
Rest in peace.
Put one out for the lost.
I am, can destroy them.
Yep.
That's what you get for taking one of ours. Yes.
Oh, this is beautiful. This.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see as the light changes as you get into this icy temperature.
Yeah.
How the world just can look completely different.
Uh-oh. What is this? Oh my god. Okay.
And, oh.
No, don't antagonize it. What are you doing?
I don't think they have a chance.
Oh. Well, this is going to be a great opportunity for you to sneak around and not even get involved in this one. Let them...
Just let them fight.
Yeah, let them have their...
I think the mammoth's got it.
No, no, I'm good.
It's so big.
Just think how bad a day you must be having when you think, oh, I've got those pesky villagers, and then suddenly there's a huge animal behind you. Yeah, I would just hide.
Like, oh,
let it do its thing.
So I think we might be safe at this point.
Oh, and there's an interesting question that goes with the day and night cycle from Protocol Rain. Since Far Cry has day and night cycles, will a wait feature be implemented in the game?
So at every outpost that you conquer and every bonfire that you claim as well, you'll have a sleeping fur bed that you can rest on. And there you can choose to rest until the next morning or the next evening, so that you can get into more day-based gameplay or night-based gameplay.
Yeah, or you can just stand there in the open world and wait for the day and the night cycle.
Exactly, you can just allow it to happen.
Yeah. Okay, really nice.
Because I guess to reiterate what you'd said before, there's certain perils of nighttime that aren't, you know, in daytime and vice versa. Certain animals come out.
When you start to play the game, you may even want to not be around at night. And you may want to use the daytime to gather materials and craft some better weapons initially.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Okay. That is really beautiful.
Oh, man. Impressive.
Another benefit of having no light pollution.
Yay! Nice.
And down we go.
Really nice. Okay. Thank you, JJ.
We have a lot of people asking a particular question.
Yeah, well, you want to take this?
Yeah, sure. So, Delirious Insomniac and everyone else, are there different difficulty settings?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are. Just like the other Far Cry games, we have a choice of easy, medium, and hard.
Okay.
And it's up to you how you'd like to play. And you can switch that at any time as well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There you go. Answered the question. Quickly take one again. Cross the Eagle 753. What is the Udam tribe based on?
Well, the whole world, when we started looking at where it could be based, we know from our research that a lot of tribes were migrating through Europe many thousands of years ago, and they ended up moving through and settling in Central Europe. So ultimately, we're looking at the Central European population of the time. Mm. But again, because of the Udam being trapped so far north for so long, they ended up inbreeding, and so they're a very different species almost of people. And you can see they're very primitive. They have that classic sort of troglodyte caveman vibe going on.
Yeah.
Cool.
Okay, awesome. I guess, yeah, we can keep taking some more questions.
Sure.
Yeah.
Bleed the painter, not panther. I'm too in Far Cry mode now. I thought it was a panther. Two questions. Do the Azilla and Udam fight each other, and do you go to the beginning area again? So I guess where you start.
Yeah, so that initial starting area, it's where you find yourself trapped and separated from the rest of your tribe. Mm-hmm. So your initial task is to really escape that area. Mm-hmm. And when you finally get out of it, that's the end of it, really. Okay. And then you're moving on into the world of Oros, but that's really where you want to be.
Yeah.
It's where you want to develop your tribe and grow it some more.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Cool. Very nice. All right, do you want to take that one before we go on to the raffle?
From Apocalypto?
Yeah.
I can't quite pronounce his name.
Apocalypto for the win.
Yes. The skill tree is bigger than Far Cry 4. It is absolutely bigger. Yeah. We have somewhere in the region of 70 different skills in the game.
Okay.
And the The great thing is that we decided to attach different branches of the skill tree to the different specialist characters in the world.
Okay.
So it's another great reason to go out and find those specialists like Jaima.
Yeah.
And
like we showed before.
Exactly.
Yeah, with the cosplay.
And so as you start to gather all those specialists back and bring them to your village, they're going to unlock new branches on the skill tree for you, which match their specialist needs.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Jaima, she's a hunter.
Yeah.
She's going to help you improve your bow skills. She's going to unlock new bows for you as well over time.
Yeah.
And as you build her hut up in her village, she's going to teach you new skills as well.
Nice. Okay. Very interesting.
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
Raffle time.
Raffle time.
Raffle time.
I see excited in your eyes.
I had let it slip. I'd seen a few people in chat going, raffle? Okay.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Raffle time. So this one is really cool.
Yes.
Because do you want to pass it on?
Shall I?
Yes. The raffle's open, by the way, in case you didn't know already.
Yeah, yeah.
But this is a collector's edition. Let's display that right there.
Yes.
This is fascinating. I'm going to open it up so you can see what's in there. But yeah,
very
one
slow.
Lucky winner is going to get this. Yeah, okay. So, like, to start with, look at that.
Rawr.
Did you like my roar?
We did.
Okay. So,
and this is what you can win in this raffle.
So, in the collector's edition, we'll start with the game itself.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, whoever wins will get this on their platform of
choice,
right?
Yeah. This is like PS4, but it can be PC or...
To display. You know. So you have it there. The game.
Mm-hmm.
Then you will get some bonus
digital
stuff.
Content.
Do you want to talk about the bonus content?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, we can. Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Sweet.
Well,
that's it. So there are some exclusive missions.
Yes.
The Legend of the Mammoth missions.
Yes.
Yeah.
And basically, you get to beat a mammoth in those missions.
Ooh, what?
And play as a mammoth and help your tribe of mammoths.
I love your look. What?
That's awesome.
Yeah. Cool.
There's also an exclusive weapon.
Yes.
It's the Bone Shasky Club.
Mm-hmm.
It's a new type of club, different from the others. It's very strong. It's very powerful.
Mm.
It is based around the Udam philosophy.
Right.
And so it's going to be really great for you
awesome.
To help have another layer of strategy when you're fighting in the world.
Yeah.
And there's also some different packs of extra content you can have.
Yeah,
so you're going to find different items that are put into your stash, different plant types and things to help you get a head start in the crafting features in the game.
Yeah.
But also different skins for the animals in the world,
right.
Especially your owl.
So they look differently.
Exactly, yep.
Okay.
That's awesome.
A little visual signifier.
Yeah.
That's amazing. All right, so that's that's the extra content you'll get in there. The next thing is the soundtrack, which Matthias had mentioned earlier. Just make sure you can see that. There you go.
There's
so the soundtrack.
OG CD inside.
And there's what, 30-something tracks?
33
tracks? 33, it looks like.
Yeah.
So that's a lot of soundtrack.
Yeah.
And there's one of them, I think it's track number 8, that is already on YouTube.
All right,
okay.
Listen,
so yeah,
you know,
go head over there.
Listen to.
Then, I'm a sucker for these. Steelbook.
Yes.
Boom. Steelbook time, make sure. There we go, yeah.
Yeah.
So that image you're all familiar
metallic
with.
Metallic finish.
Steelbook. And
can you open it?
Yeah, I'm going to open it because what's really cool about this is that it's got two little disc slots there, so you can put your soundtrack in one.
You can.
And the game disc in another.
Yes. Bam.
Look at that saber tooth.
It looks really good.
I just want to go around petting animals and taming them.
Yeah.
And being the ultimate beastmaster. Then this is really cool.
Mm-hmm.
So we have the map.
Yeah.
This is beautiful.
I'm going to open it real quick so you see. Don't want to spoil too much.
No.
So I'm just going to show this really quickly.
There you go.
The map.
Yep.
Right.
Very quick
there.
Map.
Oh.
Yep.
Damn.
Good job.
There.
And we, yep.
There we go.
Oh, yep. There we go.
There it is.
There we go.
Good job.
Like I said, we don't want to spoil too much. So
the paper map.
That, yeah. And this, phrasebook. You get a Wenja phrasebook. So the actual language.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That is fantastic. Because you can say all sorts of things in Wenja. Do you guys go around speaking in Wenja on the dev floor?
We try not to, but sometimes it slips out.
Yeah.
All that research we did into making that language, we decided to try and find a
That's
way that
really
we can share that with everyone.
Yeah,
that is
yeah.
amazing.
Yeah.
So yeah, you get that. All of that in the collector's
edition.
Which
and
one person is going to win?
Yes, exactly.
That's fantastic.
I don't know if we already have the winner from our moderation team. Almost there.
And
yep,
winner
still
is Escoblades. Yay, me!
Okay.
No. Cool.
That's a lot of content.
Yes,
that is.
It is.
And that box is really cool as well.
Yeah. I like the way
opening.
It opens up.
Yeah, me too. This is fantastic.
So, Maddie, we're going to talk afterwards, yeah?
Yes, we are.
Excellent. Right, I'll put that back in. And like we said, the winner will get this on their platform of choice.
Yep. And you know, if you don't win it, you can always pre-order it now if you want.
Yes.
In the chat, there will be the link. Even if you just want to look at the content and see what different versions you want to choose, you can always do that.
Because this is out on what platforms?
Yeah. It's all on our platforms.
All of them. Yeah. All the platforms. That's Xbox One, PS4.
PS4 and PC.
PC.
I believe so, yeah.
Make sure. Because, I'm still kind of new to Far Cry Primal, so I want to make sure I have all the information I need.
Yes.
So that when I get in, I'm hitting the ground running.
I guess we can take one question from Far Cry Universe.
Okay. Sure.
What challenges did you face during the development of Far Cry Primal?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think it was really, when we knew that we wanted to make a game set in the Stone Age,
mm-hmm.
it was about getting that research aspect done.
Yeah.
And then when we knew that we had, we'd gotten our location set and we knew that this was the right time of, with the Stone Age setting, for Far Cry to be set in, the next challenge for us was really, how do we make our core gameplay work in this new universe? We really spent a lot of time figuring out how we were going to reinvent our core combat loop, how we were going to reinvent hunting, how we were going to reinvent everything, navigation around the world. And so that led us to develop these new systems that you've been seeing, how you can use a lot more melee weapons in the game, how you can throw your weapons, set them on fire, have a lot more depth and strategy with your weapons. And then on top of that, how hunting is going to work when you're stripped of the traditional gadgets that you've had from previous Far Cry games.
Absolutely.
So that way, Hunter Vision came into play, and the ability to spot blood trails and tracks in the world really helped to sell the experience.
Yeah, and also the trail that you leave behind you on the minimap.
Exactly, that's
you,
it. Yeah. The whole world, if you want to explore the world and uncover the map, well, you have to walk around and uncover it directly.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
Great.
Awesome. And we have a winner.
I think we almost have a winner, right?
We do.
Yeah.
And that congratulations to Helion T.
Yes.
And you have won yourself collector's edition of Far Cry Primal. I did see a question in the chat real quick about how many pages were in the phrasebook. And so I'm not 100% sure.
Big.
Yeah, it was quite, I mean, like, there was 60 plus.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, because I'm not 100% sure how final that particular one is,
Or whether it's going to change.
It's pretty final, so there were about 60 plus pages.
Yeah, yeah,
like, there's a lot of...
No, there's a lot of content.
You're going to be speaking Wenger by the time you're done.
When you learn this.
You're going to be...
Okay.
You're going to be
and
taking
so the
care
winner,
of.
Did you give him a shot?
Yes,
yeah, you did.
Helion T.
Okay, yeah, there you go.
So congratulations on that.
All right, so, I think we are going to the end of the stream.
We're done.
Congratulations to the three guys, three people that win on the raffle. I just wanted to thank, our awesome guests that were with us. Julien again, Clark, thank you.
Thanks so much, and Alonzi.
Yep. Andy.
Thanks for having me on.
But also the moderation team, Stephanie, Andrew, Antoine and the camera, all, the dev team, obviously, who is probably also watching.
And the mods in the chat.
The mods in the chat.
Awesome.
Thank you, and thanks to you, the viewers, the players, our fans. Thank you for being with us. And we hope to see you soon.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Cheers.
Bye. 18.
Guam. Tishai. Gas.